guys. I'm Cate Torrealba, known as Beauty by Miss Ruby on Instagram. I am on the CosmoProf artistic team, and today I'm going to be showing you guys some really fun short hairstyling on my model, Erica. Oh my gosh, that was really hard to say. She actually just cut her hair into a bit of a longer pixie hairstyle, and I have Sarai, the Platinum Giraffe, who's one of our Cosmo Pros, behind the camera today. She actually just did Erica's color on Monday. She did this amazing silvery platinum blonde color. So once we get her dried, you'll be able to see her color. If you have questions for Sarai about her color, she's right here.
Hi.
She can answer those for you. So I wanted to show you guys how to do some really fun kind of tousled hairstyles for pixie cuts, because I feel like a lot of people don't know what to do with pixie haircuts and they don't think that they're very versatile. And I'm here to tell you that pixie haircuts are versatile as heck and you can get so many looks out of them. Do not be afraid of short hair. I feel like a lot of stylists are afraid of cutting short hair and styling short hair, and their clients are also afraid of those things. So I'm gonna show you some really easy styling tips on how to make your clients look great and feel really fantastic about their short hair. So Erica's hair is damp right now, and my new favorite product for creating volume and lift is from Pravana. This is the Pravana Full Volume. This is a volumizing foam product. Absolutely love this. I'll start out with about 2 to 3 pumps in damp hair, and then I dry that in rough with my hands. And it gives me really, really great base for getting lift and body out of my short hairstyle. So I'm just gonna start out with 2 pumps. If I feel like I need more after I get that worked in, then I can absolutely go back in, work more in. By the way, I'm in my home studio right now in North Hollywood. I live in Los Angeles. I'm a hairdresser out here for red carpet, special occasion styling, weddings, photo shoots, editorial, all that good stuff. And my husband and I have a studio in our home where we shoot. So that is where we are coming to you live from today. If you guys have any questions at all, please feel free to holler them out and Sarai will read them. Doesn't even have to necessarily be just about short hair styling, because I do all kinds of different styling.
Maggie says you and your model are gorgeous.
It's all Erica. She's fantastic. She's our little Marilyn.
Maggie, we agree.
She's fantastic. And Sarai, you just need to turn the camera around on yourself. Before we started, Sarai was like, teach me about wigs. I own like 30 different wigs. And so I put this wig on Sarai before we started. Look how fantastic she looks.
I look like a real life Barbie doll right now.
Doesn't she need to have this color? She's like hot pink and yellow, but she needs to be lavender. Like this needs to happen.
All the time.
So I've gotten that completely worked through all the hair. So it's a nice taper up the back here. And I just work that through with my hands. And then I'm gonna rough dry her with my blow dryer. What side do you want to part on?
Whatever.
Doesn't matter. So I'm gonna put my blow dryer on and I'm just gonna rough dry her. I also have one of my Framar detangling brushes. These are my absolute fave when I'm doing a rough dry style. So I like to push this in every direction because I want to get a lot of lift out of it. And I just work my way around, drying in every direction. Do a lot of you guys have short hair clients? I'm always curious about that. I love working on short hair. And about a month ago, I actually cut all of my hair off. My hair was about shoulder length, and I had wanted to do a pixie cut so bad. I had to ease my husband into it. I had to mentally prepare him for like 2 months. This was my compromise, because I actually wanted to shave my head, but I was like, I'll just get a really short haircut instead. So I'm just going in every direction, using my hands. I use my hands a lot when I'm styling. It's the best tool that you have, especially when you're going to be doing kind of a tousled, undone look.
Now, Ruby, do you have a favorite blow dryer?
I use so many different ones. This is the new Ion blow dryer that's going to be in. It's the Magnesium Pro. I'm not sure if this is in CosmoProf yet or if it's shortly going to be available in CosmoProf. Like, I had gotten this one before they launched in December. I also have a Rust blow dryer that I really like, and my Babyliss Pro. I have like 10 different blow dryers. Because I'm always traveling, I'm all over the place, and my kit is always packed and ready to go to be on location. I'm actually going to be styling at the Oscars on Sunday, and I'm so excited. I just got my credentials sent to me, and they told me that after I'm done styling, if I want to go down to the red carpet, I can. And I'm like, oh yeah, I might take a peek down at the red carpet while I'm there, you know, just real quick.
You're going to show up in a gown.
Yeah. Right. We'll see. I should. I should have a gown in my car ready to go.
Ruby, what are you wearing?
I'm wearing H&M Classic. That's what I'm wearing. Once I get to this top part here, I'll use my Fermar detangling brush just so I can get a little bit more lift out of the top and so it doesn't get tangled. And again, I'm blow drying in every direction so I can get really nice lift. One of my clients is an on-air host for Turner Classic Movies, and she's always on the red carpet for all of these events, and I'm really lucky that I get to go and be a part of the Oscars on Sunday, so I'm super excited. Who knows what I'll wear? Probably all black, because that's what people who work behind the scenes wear, and wearing all black for me kind of kills my soul. I'm such a, like, color person. And I have a more loud personality, so I probably shouldn't show up in like blaze orange or anything.
Oh, CosmoProf posted the link for the Ion Magnesium hair dryer.
Oh, good. It is live.
Yeah.
Because I really like this blow dryer. It's super lightweight. It packs a powerful punch.
You're getting a lot of comments that say that's amazing and congratulations.
Yay, thank you. Yeah, I'm really excited. I've done clients for the Oscars and the Grammys and the Golden Globes in the past, but it's usually just at my studio. It's not actually there. And I've been down there before when they've been prepping. The very first year that I was living in Los Angeles, my mom came out to visit me, and it just happened to be the weekend of the Oscars. And I brought her to Hollywood the day before when they were setting up, and they were doing all the dry runs with celebrities and all of the people that were there to host. And it was really, really cool to have her first, like, Hollywood experience be at the Oscars. So I'm really excited.
Jeff Coyle says he'll be doing hair for the Oscars as well.
Yay! Get your credentials! We'll get on the red carpet together. I'll probably frame my credentials afterwards and be like, baby's first Oscars.
I love all the volume you're creating just by using your fingers.
Yeah, it's easier to get through the hair. Rather than going through and like really blowing everything out perfectly, especially on short hair, I want this to be a really tousled, effortless looking style. My husband and I did a photo shoot with Erica about 2 weeks ago, yeah? I did this same exact style on her that day, and I was able to get about 5 looks out of her hair just from like repositioning, rebrushing, just flipping the part over to the other side, and it had so much versatility. So I always tell women not to be afraid to cut their hair short, because you're going to be able to get so many more looks out of it than somebody who just wears their hair in a ponytail every single day. So I want to get this 100% dry.
So somebody's asking what products you're using, and so far you just have the Pravana.
It's just the Pravana, the full volume.
Okay. That's it.
Just this so far.
I need that.
Yeah, that stuff is amazing.
It is. It's super lightweight. You can't feel it in your hair, but it gives you really, really great volume. Erica and I call ourselves Team 5 Hairs because together we only have 5 hairs. So that was one of the reasons why both of us cut our hair short, is because we're able to get so much more lift and volume and body out of the little bit of hair that we have, where we gave up on trying to grow our hair long. I wanted to be one of those Instagram models with the boho hair, especially since I live in Southern California and you see all the beach wave models and they look gorgeous. And I'm like, you know what? I better just go get a men's haircut because this is just not happening for me at all. I literally went to the barbershop down the street like a week and a half ago. I got a pixie cut like a month ago and then I was like, I just want a fade. So I went to the barbershop and I got a fade because I am not scared. So now that she is all dry, I'm gonna fire up. This is my GHD Platinum Plus styler, my new favorite flat iron ever. Absolutely love this. Turn it on and it is heated up in about 30 seconds. I prefer using a flat iron on really short hair over a curling iron because I have much more control. And especially for my clients, when they're doing this themselves at home, it can be a little bit tricky when your hair is really short and you're fumbling around with a curling iron. You can burn yourself really easily, whether it's your hands or your scalp. So it's much easier to get in towards the scalp and actually create the kind of texture that you want much more easily for yourself and for your clients. So I always like to start on the sides. I'll move to the back and then I'll do this top section here. And I'll just kind of play around seeing what side I'm gonna get the most lift from. And pretty much either side. I think I'm gonna go to this side because I'm gonna get a really nice amount of lift out of it coming this way. So I'll start on the sides. And I always, when I'm curling, I like to work from the bottom coming up to the top. So you'll wanna have a comb handy and a couple of duckbill clips. And if you have never curled with a flat iron before, it is gonna be your new best friend. It's so much quicker and easier once you get the hang of it. When you're by the face, you wanna curl away from the face. And then everywhere else, I like to alternate my curls. So this one here by the face, I'm gonna curl away. And it's essentially like curling a ribbon with a scissors. If you're a gift wrapper out there, I was the gift wrapper in the family growing up, so I got real good with the ribbon curls. You're basically gonna take your section, depending on how you want your curls to look, usually by the face, I'm gonna be holding it horizontally. You're gonna put the hair in, you're gonna close it, you're gonna turn it over one time, and you're gonna pull. So the slower you go, the tighter your curl is gonna be, the faster you go, the looser it's gonna be. And I like to leave the ends out so they're a little bit more straight. I want it to have that beachy sort of texture to it, that undone or that bedroom hair, I like to call it. So that's basically what this is gonna look like. So I'm gonna put this in here, I'm gonna close it, turn it over one time, and pull out, and we have our little curl there.
Look at how cute that guy is.
I know, cute little curl. And I guarantee you by the end of this video, all of you, I'm sure you're watching this in your salons, you're gonna look at whoever's sitting next to you and you're gonna ask them to cut all your hair off because it's really cute.
Short hair is life.
Short hair really is life. All three of us here have short hair. I always like to comb out my sections too. I like to make everything really sleek and really clean. So now I'm going the opposite direction so that that is going towards the face. And then I'm just gonna alternate all the way around. If it's by the face, I'm gonna go away just so that I don't have hair falling into her face.
So do you leave your curls to cool?
It depends on what I'm doing. So a lot of what I do is that old Hollywood glam. If I'm doing old Hollywood glam, I'm gonna clip every single curl with a pin curl clip and I'm gonna let them cool down. If I'm doing tousled beach waves, I'm not gonna do that because I want it to have an undone texture. If you're using the pins, it's gonna cool down in that shape and it's gonna give you a much tighter curl. So it's not gonna have as much of an undone sort of appearance to it. So for something like this, I wouldn't. I would just let it off the iron and hang out to cool down that way. So again, this one by the face, I'm gonna curl back, but then I'm gonna alternate my other sections.
What is this flat iron called again? The GHD?
GHD Platinum Plus.
And the link is just a couple comments above yours. The CosmoProf has put the link up for that flat iron as well.
Gosh, that's nice.
They're on it.
Yeah, that's amazing. I wish everybody would do that.
And I've been a GHD person for almost 13 years now, since the first salon that I worked at. If you get a curl that you feel like is too tight, you could always tug down on it a little bit afterwards. I like having that texture in there and a lot of curl so that I can have versatility in changing my styles, especially since I work on set a lot and I have to do hairstyle changes with wardrobe changes. I want to be able to flip it around and get different looks out of it without having to curl it again.
I like the shape of that iron.
It fits in your hand. It's not one of those like flat irons. I don't know. It just, the way that it curves, it fits in your hand really nicely and you get really nice curls out of it. So again, pulling straight out. And I'm leaving the ends out a little bit, so the ends are a little bit straighter. So instead of continuing my curl, I pull down just a little bit so that it gets a straighter end on it. While I'm working, I like to use a working hairspray, and I like a hairspray that's drier. So my favorite is Sexy Hair Get Layered. This is a flash drying buildable hairspray. So you're able to build this to the amount of hold that you want. And this is the only hairspray that I'm gonna use on Erica. After I finish the section, I like to spray it a little bit with that just to keep the hold in there, and then I keep moving along, and I'm still able to get a comb, a brush, or my hands through that hairspray after I've finished. So again, comb out. Who's working in the salon right now? Who's working and who's off today? What day is it? Thursday?
It is.
I lose track of my days easily. I always try and think of what my row below this row is doing too. I don't want to repeat the exact same pattern on every row because I want the curls to kind of interlock with each other and look more like a natural curl pattern as opposed to being curled with a curling iron or a flat iron. So because this one right below this curl is curled going forward, I'm still going to curl this one going back even though this first one is. I just want it to have more of a natural texture to it. I don't want it to look too uniform. You can also grab different size sections of the curls that you're going to be curling to give an even more natural appearance.
You got a bunch of people watching this at work right now.
Yay!
It just looks so easy the way you do that. It looks, it's very smooth.
I've been like such a fan of GHD for so long that they're the only irons that I've ever purchased. I've had other irons sent to me and nothing compares to GHD. And then Sinead O'Connor plays in my head, nothing compares to you. And that's just how I feel about GHD. I always have, since the very first salon that I worked at was a GHD salon.
Now, can you talk a little bit about this sectioning that you're kind of
yes.
doing? Because I feel like a lot of people get lost in the back on
okay.
short hair.
So sectioning for me, I am a really big advocate of clean sectioning. I have to clean section everything. So whenever I'm working on any style, doesn't matter, I always ask my client what side they part their hair on, and I do whatever their side is, and then I go from just behind the ears over to the other side. So I have a big side section over here from where she parts, and then this smaller side section, and then I have my whole section in the back. And I just take horizontal partings going all the way up, and I like, because I'm right-handed, I work from the left going over to the right so that I'm not fighting over other curls. So with this stuff being so short down here, I'm just gonna give it a bit of a bend, and it's not gonna be as sectioned out as cleanly as I normally would. But I'll just section it out and give these a little bit of bend, and then I'll continue going up the hair, taking horizontal partings, and I like to really keep it clean and clip everything out of the way so that I'm not fighting over any other hair while I'm curling. So let me move here for you guys so you can really see the back. So now, the hair is too short to even do anything, like in my own hair, I just have like this little kind of triangular section. And I just kind of grab back there and I curl whatever I feel like I can grab onto. So if your pixie is too short for that, just try and give it a little bit of a bend so that it's not bone straight in comparison to everything else.
So Liz has a pricing question, and I know that I know your answer for this, Ruby.
Yes.
She says, do you upcharge after a cut or color service to do a wavy or curly style like this?
I would, for sure, because it's going to take you extra time in the salon and it takes away from any other clients that you have coming in. Your time is worth money and you're worth that. So if they want to see that extra style to it, I would absolutely upcharge for that, for sure. There's somebody else, I can't remember who it is, they just posted about that on Instagram, that they charge $15 for curls.
It was Gianna Bianca.
Okay.
Hair doctor.
Yes.
And she did a price breakdown that's yes. very interesting.
It is.
Over a year, how much money you can make or lose by not charging.
For curls.
For curls, absolutely.
Just a really easy thing, curls. Because if you think about that, if you have, you know, four clients that you add curls onto in that day, that's 2 hours of your day, you know? Depending on how thick their hair is, if you're spending, you know, 15 minutes on each one of those,
it adds
20
up.
Minutes. So I'm just giving a tiny bit of a bend. I'm kind of going in opposite directions because once this is messed up, I just don't want it to be super, super straight. And pixies, I feel like you have to spend more time on that than you would on long hair because you really have to get in on all those little corners and everything just to make everything look perfect. On long hair, beach wave, you can kind of fudge that a little bit. So see how on these, I can get in and it's like touches her skin and it doesn't burn her. If you're doing that with a curling iron, you can easily, you know, burn yourself or burn your client. So that's why I prefer using the flat iron to get in there. So I'm gonna take down my next row. And it can be pretty big sections back here because the hair is so short. Just so that it has a little bit of that bend there. Have enough duckbill clips handy to hold up any of those.
Do you prefer duckbill clips as opposed to any other type of clip? And if so, why?
I do. So I prefer just regular metal duckbill clips. I don't like the ones that have all the teeth in it. Unless you have somebody that's got really super thick hair and you need to like hold a big section up. Because again, I don't like getting any sort of like indentations in the hair. I don't like it getting messed up. And I feel like the ones that have teeth in them, they tend to like leave marks behind. And I always just carry the smooth ones in my kit.
This is a funny question. Hello from Toronto. Do you think it's unprofessional to have a client hold down their ear while you're working around it?
What if you burn them is the only thing. Like, what if you burn their hand? I never do it. I've been doing hair for 13 years, and I guess I've just kind of learned to work around those things. It's funny because when we were coloring the other day and Sarai and I were doing some models, she was like, man, can't we just make ears come off at this point? And I'm like, oh my gosh, I wish that was a thing, but
they just get in the way.
They do get in the way, and it can be really annoying to have the ears in the way, but I guess I wouldn't make them hold their ear down doing it because you're the one providing the service, if that makes sense. And then how are they supposed to learn to do it themselves at home too then? How are they gonna like be holding the section and doing it and while holding their ear down? So I would just try and figure out how to do it to work around the ear itself. like for myself with my hair, a lot of times I'll do this, but I'll make the whole top like really big and curly. And I used to have longer hair on the sides, and I would basically just kind of like brush it back around my ear and not get in there with the iron super close. So now this hair is a little bit longer here, so I'm actually able to get in and start creating the same sort of curl pattern as I was doing on the side. So I'm gonna be alternating these sections. So now this one went this way, the next one's gonna come the other way. And again, comb through your sections. That's a huge thing for me. I'm big on my sections being really clean, because if it's not and you have any sort of tangles in there or there's any sort of product buildup, once you get the iron on there, it's gonna kind of cook it in that shape, and it's gonna make it harder for you to style once you're done curling. Spray a little bit with my Get Layered. It adds a little bit of texture to the style too. So for something like this, especially on fine hair, adding as much texture as you possibly can while you're working is gonna help. You can just layer your products to get the right amount of texture out of it. And this really shouldn't take you that long. The last couple of times that I've done this on Erica, we've either been filming videos or, you know, doing tutorials, and so I really take my time going through every single step and talking about everything, but this really shouldn't take you longer than 15 minutes to do the whole thing.
Maggie would like to know, where did you get your combs?
I got them at CosmoProf. This is the Cleopatra 441 comb. These are my absolute favorite combs. When I'm doing styling, I don't like to use foiling combs, especially for when I'm working on the surface. Like the style that I did on Sarai, I was showing her how to do this. It makes everything really nice and smooth. It's a really ultra fine comb. And foiling combs tend to be a little bit more wide tooth as opposed to this comb.
I'm gonna show the teeth on this comb because it really does.
It's really, really
make
fine.
A difference. And it's the 441 Cleopatra.
Yes. And then the brush that I used while I was doing her rough dry is the Framar detangle brush. If you guys do not have a Framar detangle brush, you need to run right now, buy them at CosmoProf.
They're literally the best brushes
they are.
I have ever used.
They really
in my
are.
Life.
They sent me one about a month ago that had my dog Moose on it. It was so cute. And I told them that I didn't even want to use it because it was so cute. So then they sent me a box of them, and now I'm just completely obsessed. They're the best brushes I've ever used.
I actually use them, and I know you don't do color, Ruby, but I use them when I'm doing my color melting work, and they are phenomenal for that.
Yes,
as well.
They really get through the hair. As I'm moving up to the top, I overdirect and I elevate. So when I'm getting my iron in there, I'm really pulling up and over and overdirecting my section, because as you can see, like from here to here, I'm getting a lot of lift at the scalp there, which I'm gonna want when I go through and I actually style. So as I'm working up the scalp here, I'm thinking, how much lift do I wanna have? If I didn't want to have much lift, I would really lower my elevation on my iron and pull more down. I'm starting to pull up so I can get a lot of lift. Because as short hair gals, we got to make it look like we have more hair than we do, especially us with fine hair.
CosmoProf, we love you for putting all of these links up on
yes.
the website for all of these products. Thank you.
See, even that one that I went the other way, I pulled way up so I can get that nice elevation on my curl.
That's a really pretty curl.
Thanks.
Really pretty.
It's like I've done it before.
Maybe once or twice, right?
Maybe. I'll never forget. Okay, if you can't curl with a flat iron, please don't feel bad and just practice a lot. The very first salon that I ever worked at, we would have reps from GHD come in and teach us how to do this stuff. And I swear to you, I was like a T-Rex. Like, I couldn't figure it out. I couldn't get the tension right. One thing that I can highly suggest to you is don't push down too hard. Don't clamp your flat iron too hard. You want to be able to like get it through, because if you clamp it down,
I've done that. And I'm like, skip, 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 skip.
Yes,
it's like, hers is like nice and smooth, and mine has like ridges in it because I'm like, bub, 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 bub.
And that was so mean. I'm like, this sucks. I'm never curling with a flat iron again. And now I can't get away from it because it seriously is. If it's too much, it's like. And it's like you're having a seizure trying to like get the flat iron out of the hair. It does not work.
Anybody who's ever done this is rolling on the floor right now because they get it.
It's true.
Yeah. So it just takes practice. I promise you. I make it look easy because I've done it a million times. And then again, spritz a little bit of my working spray.
We have a question. Yes. Do you have a favorite place to get a mannequin from that's good for heat styling or even coloring?
Yes, Pivot Point. Pivot Point makes the... Okay, I'm going to be totally honest with you. Most mannequins look like they've been through a house fire. Like, they're just not pretty. They are not cute. They look sad and scary. And I know all of you from beauty school probably, like, used your mannequin heads as Halloween decorations at some point because they are scary. And Pivot Point makes the most beautiful mannequin heads ever. And that's... Those are my favorite. I have my one Pivot Point mannequin that is just to die for. She's pretty. And I know Mustafa just launched one too that's really, really beautiful. And I want it, but I'm saving my pennies for that one. Spritz. Now I'm gonna move to working on this side. I always save this top section for last. And this is basically my whole front and money shot. So what I like to do is section this part out separate from the rest. And it's basically a big rectangle on top of the head. I'm gonna have you tip your head forward for me. So you can see it's like the entire top of her head. So we'll clip that out of the way. We'll save that for last. I'm gonna do the side here.
Everything you do is so neat and organized.
Yeah, it has to be. And it actually, I'm a little embarrassed because like this part here isn't perfectly straight and it's bothering me.
We're all judging.
But, yeah, everybody's gonna judge. Don't judge my part. Yeah, I'm really, really clean about my work. And
somebody said, yes, Viola from Pivot Point. I think that I
yes.
have Viola. Yeah.
I should go and dig mine out. I have so many mannequin heads. And I can't remember which one it is that I have, but they're so pretty. They're the prettiest mannequins. So again, when it's by the face, you're going to curl away from the face. I'm sure we've all heard that until we're blue in the face.
Unless you want 1980s.
Oh my God. We
hair.
I mean, I do. I'm not even going to lie. So ever since I cut my hair short and when I wear it like really messy curly on top, I bring it to the front and I've been rocking my like faded jean jacket and everyone keeps telling me that I'm rocking major 80 vibes. And I think it's time for us to bring the 80s back. I'm such a fan of the
Just
80s.
Just no mall bangs.
No.
No.
Erica's.
Yes. No. No moments.
Oh my. No. Have you guys watched Making a Murderer? Because I haven't watched the second season, but I watched the first season. And I'm from the Midwest. I'm originally from Minneapolis. And I went to college before I went to beauty school. And I went to college in Wisconsin. And I started watching Making a Murderer. And I thought it was filmed in the 80s. No, it's like present day. And it's really like that. In the small towns. Because I went to college in Menominee, Wisconsin. There's like...
I'm sorry, what?
Yes.
Monopoly?
Menominee.
Menominee. Spell that.
Menominee. That's what it happens for. That's where I went to college. Yeah. So, small town, Wisconsin, I love you. I do miss the cheese. I'm not gonna lie. The roadside cheese stands. I'm trying to like describe to my husband what a cheese curd is. My husband's from Brazil. And he's like, that sounds disgusting. I'm like, you should shut your mouth. Because cheese curds are delicious, first of all. And if they're the good uncooked ones that you get at like the roadside stops, they squeak in your teeth when you bite them.
They're so good.
Please, is there anybody from the Midwest watching right now? Validate me.
I was like,
Validate me. My husband's like making a disgusted face.
Midwest people need to stick together. Come on, chime in, people.
Squeaky cheese is the best. I'm now dairy-free. I have been for like 5 years, and I've been squeak-free for 5 years, and I miss that squeaky cheese so much. Look at that little perfect little ribbon. Spritz a little bit. And then this will be our last row, and then we'll work on the top. But I'm sure if you're living in the Midwest, you know someone that still rocks their mom.
Here we go. Oh, cheese curds are amazing.
Yes.
They sound gross. They don't always look good, but they are.
They are so good.
We have somebody from Madison, Wisconsin.
Yes, Madison.
Cheeseheads.
Yes. You know the business. And you know those roadside cheese stops too. Man, we used to stop at those in college all the time.
Now I want cheese. Thanks.
We can do that.
Squeaky cheese.
We can get you some squeaky cheese.
Not here in California.
Not here. No, it's vegan.
We got some good vegan cheese. Okay. Mm-hmm. Follow your heart. They make the best. They're my fave. Follow your heart. Smoke Gouda. We should just go to the store and get that. And I'll make
Somebody said Grandpa's Cheese Barn. I don't know what that is, but that sounds amazing. I'm so into that.
Yes. So far, this is how everything looks all the way around.
It's so pretty already.
I know. Like, just wait till I like, because all I'm going to do to style this, I'm not going to use a single brush. I'm going to use my mitts right here. And I'm just going to rake through it, and it turns out so cute.
So, Ruby, can we talk about nails real quick?
I have, okay.
No, that's what I'm saying. So, I have these, and people always tell me, oh, they're amazing. They're great for picking through the hair, but that's about it.
I am embarrassed because I have the ugliest hands on the planet. But let me tell you, I kind of have to because of the intricate styling that I do. I can't have anything get caught in my nails. So, I have the hands of a 10-year-old boy.
They're not that bad.
I have no nails. Even my ring will like get caught and it drives me crazy, so I'll like take it off when I'm working sometimes. And I can't with nails. So anytime I've taught somebody a hands-on class, they always come with nails on, and then they're like, oh my god, I have to get rid of my nails. I can't do it. So I'm gonna start in the back and I'm gonna work my way to the front. So I'm taking, again, horizontal partings. Clip this out of the way. And you know what? I'm trying to figure out the best way to do this. I'm going to have you tip your head forward so that they can see. And all of this stuff, I'm basically going to be having come back away from the face, but I'm still going to be alternating, if that makes sense. And I'm going to show you what I mean by that. So I'm going to split this into two. I'm going to stand behind her. And one I'm going to have come this way, one I'm going to have come the other way, but it's coming back away from the face. So I'm pulling up, and I'm curling in this way.
Ooh, that's fancy.
So see how much lift I got out of that?
I can see through that curl. Holy wowza.
So now I'm going to do it the same way, but going the opposite direction. And pull straight up away from the scalp so you get that nice lift. And you have that base product of the Pravana in there, giving you that really nice body. She's got a nice body. Adding extra nice body to it. So again, my next section, I'm gonna do the same thing, and then opposite from this curl, so I'm gonna curl this way, and then the other one, I'm gonna curl the other way. If you want, you can split these into like really small sections if you want.
Now, what would be the difference of small sections versus larger sections like you're taking?
You're going to get more texture the more sections you take. So I'm actually going to break this into three here so that I can get three different types of curls here. So with this one, I'm going to go the opposite way that I did this curl here. So again, you're going to pull straight up. And I'm going opposite from that curl behind it. So see how this one's coming this way and that one's going that way? My next one I'm gonna do this way, and then the other one I'm gonna do the opposite way.
Now, does your flat iron have a heat control on it?
It doesn't. It just stays at one setting. I believe it's like 365.
365?
Yeah.
And that's great for color treated hair as well.
Yeah, absolutely. You can go in too with an extra heat protector if you want, or a heat setting spray. My favorite is from Kenra. It's the Platinum number 20 setting spray. And then again, I'm gonna spray a little bit with my Get Layered. And I'm just gonna continue that all the way until the front. And if I get like a weird curl in the front that I feel like isn't working for the fringe, then I can kind of recurl that and get it to flow nicely so that it comes off to one side. But it usually works out pretty darn well for me doing it this way.
Yeah, we got it. I bought a GHD after I saw yours, and they were saying that it's safer to have it at 365 and keep, if you have a highly textured hair, keep it on your hair longer than it would be to buy one that's 450.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
to get it done faster.
I love that meme that goes around, and it's like you cook a pizza at 4:50, yes. Stop cooking your hair.
Yeah. Well, and the GHD like stays at 365 the whole time you use it.
Yeah, and the nice thing is it heats evenly. A lot of flat irons don't, so you're getting hot spots and cool spots. With the GHD, it's evenly heated throughout, so you don't have to continually go back over sections. And also something too, with the flat iron curls, if you curl a section and it's not as tightly curled as you want it, leave it until you're done and go back to it. Because if it's hot, it's not gonna recurl with the flat iron.
Oh, that's such a good tip.
Yeah.
You're so smart.
Because I've done that before and I'm like, why isn't this working?
Yeah.
It's like we've all done that.
You know, you curl the ribbon too much and then it just goes flat and straight. Yeah. You're like,
oh great.
Ruin that piece.
So I'm just gonna take out this really little front section here.
Baby fringe.
A little baby fringe. Oh my god, baby shark. Sarai showed me baby shark today. I had never seen baby shark.
You've never seen that video?
No.
With little kids running around
You're
the screen?
All yeah. Welcome for that.
I already know.
Well, because I keep calling Sebastian her baby boy. Yeah. Because he looks like a baby shark.
Yeah.
And I would sing it, and she had no idea, so.
Oh, yeah.
To be fair, he's a puppy. He's not a human.
Yes, I'm sorry, puppy baby. Your baby looks like a shark.
My baby does look like a shark. He does. He also looks like, I haven't seen it, but he looks like the dragon from How to Train Your Dragon.
Toothless.
My favorite, that's like my cat.
Toothless.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. He's so cute. He's all black, and he's got a little white racing stripe on his nose.
He's a Boston, correct?
He's a baby Boston. Boston's are the best.
That's what I say about my gray cat. And he chirps and makes like little noises just like Toothless does.
So cute. I'm a dog mom for life. I have two. I have two Bostons. I have Moose. He's 10 and a half. And then we have baby Bash, Sebastian. He is 5 months. And he is a holy terror. Let me tell you, he is nuts. So both of these I'm going to do coming this way because I like to have that really nice bang wave happening.
Oh my God, baby shark doo 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 doo.
Baby shark doo 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 doo. Is it mommy shark doo 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 doo? Daddy shark. Yep. I like the grandpa and grandma ones because they like don't have teeth.
My mom gets so offended by that. She's like, why does grandma not have to have any teeth? I have all my teeth still.
Still.
Someone said, would you take the same sections on top for long hair?
I would. Just to break it up. It gives you a better pattern, I feel like, and you get more lift up by the scalp than you would just taking regular, like, horizontal sections coming up. So if you want to get a lot of lift, absolutely. So I'm going to spray a little bit here.
Nina, she is using the GHD Platinum, and if you scroll up in the comments, CosmoProf has been kind enough to post a link Platinum to Platinum. That.
So I'm going to turn my flat iron off because I don't need it anymore. And I'm going to grab just a tiny little bit. This is the Kenra. It's kind of hard because the whole thing is like chrome. This is Kenra Platinum Working Wax number 15. This is my go-to pomade for all my styling. The reason I like it is because it's super lightweight and it also has a matte finish to it. So I'm just using a very small amount. The nice thing about this is you cannot go overboard with this pomade. You really can't. So I just get a little bit in my hands and then I'm just going to rake my fingers through the curls. This will help if you have any like frizziness or flyaways. And in the back, I'm just going in every direction.
Oh my God, it's so beautiful.
Thank you.
I got next.
Yes. Just use your hands. And go in every direction. You can go from underneath.
I really like how you're not afraid to get in there and work the hair.
Because if you're setting it right, if you're curling it right, your curl's gonna look nice no matter what. If you're taking the time to really section everything out, you're gonna get a nice curl pattern out of it. If you're not taking your time to do a nice curl pattern, then it's not gonna come out how you want it. So that's what I always tell people for any sort of like bridal styling or vintage styling is your set is super important. But look how cute that looks just already. Like, I don't really have to do much to it.
Yeah, everyone is loving this, you guys. Oh, and then not hair related, but y'all, skin is gorgeous.
I live in California where we are like beat by the sun all the time. So I wear sunscreen all day, every day. So even just as is, this is so cute. Now, if I want to like kick it up a notch, this is my go-to. And I know everybody has a dry texture spray now, but this is the Kenra Dry Volume Burst. Get this yesterday because this is going to be your best friend. So I use this for massive volume and texture. And I just shake it up and I spray it kind of everywhere.
Obsessed.
It will give you the most lift, the most body.
It smells good.
It smells fantastic. Smell I'm just going to say that everything from Kenra smells like candy. Amen. And unicorn dreams. Mm-hmm. So this is going to give you really good staying power, especially for those fine-haired clients like myself and Erica.
Well, and you used this on me the other day when you styled, mm-hmm. and I was able to wear my hair for 3 days without even touching it. Yep. I just kind of brushed through it and was able to just restyle it.
That's the nice thing about using this, especially when I'm working on shoots, because I can go back through and I can still manipulate the hair without having to do a whole lot to it and get a completely different look out of it. And I like a no part look too for something like this. So that's why I like to curl in different directions along the top. It just makes everything look a little bit more organic and undone. Like you didn't try to make your hair look cool, but people are gonna be like, oh my God, your hair looks so cool.
Can you show that product one more time,
yep. Maybe? Dry Volume Burst from Kenra. Comes in a short, fat little can.
Thank you.
It's the business. And especially in here, what I like to do is I like to get my fingers in the bang section and pull up and I spray it there, and I do it through the ends too, because I want everything to have that texture to it.
Kind of has a little peppermint-y.
Oh, we have a
peppermint candle.
An oil. We have one of those like oil things in the house.
I was like,
I'm obsessed with peppermint oil, and so we have one of those like, what are they called?
Diffuser.
An oil diffuser.
We have it going. Oh my god. This is so amazing.
Isn't that cute? So then what I'll do, especially if the hair is a little bit longer, I'll just go through and separate curls where I want them. And to finish, I'll just use more of that Get Layered hairspray because it has enough hold to it. I don't need to use anything that's a crazy finishing hold hairspray because I still want it to be soft, movable. And it looks so cute. It's just tousled,
so easy. Darling. This is that hair that you see on Pinterest, and you're like,
how do I do this?
Yep, and now you all know how to recreate this.
You could do this on a really cute stacked bob, on lobs too. I particularly love this for pixies because most people feel like all you can do is blow dry a pixie haircut, and however it's cut, that's how you have to wear it. And that is not true. You can wear pixies in so many different ways. I like to pull pieces up in the front with the Get Layered, just with my fingers, so that I can get more lift and kind of a different texture out of it. This is also great too. Say you're working on a wedding party and you have the one bridesmaid that has really short hair. And they always feel a little bit left out because everybody else has long hair and they're getting cute updos. Well, all the bridesmaids are going to want to hack all their hair off when they see her hair because it's going to look so cute. I can't tell you how many people have messaged me or commented on my posts since I've cut my own hair. And they're like, I was growing my hair out for the longest time, and now I made an appointment to go and get it cut.
Maggie, her Instagram handle is Beauty by Miss Ruby.
That's me. My real name is Kate, but my stage name is Ruby. Because I'm a July baby, so my dad always called me Ruby when I was little. My birth
and look
struggle.
At that. CosmoProf already has your link for Instagram. You guys are amazing.
So
we love you.
But look how cute that is. It's like modern Marilyn Monroe.
It's so adorable.
Bedroom hair. Sexy, tousled. Really easy to do.
And proof that short hair can be sexy.
It can. Don't be scared. What did Charles say?
He's like, I've always had mine short.
My husband is the biggest troll on the planet.
Troll with a good heart.
He is a troll with a good heart.
The kind with the gem on their belly.
Yes. Do you still have your ugly troll, Charles? Or did you throw it away? Charles' mom had hung on to a bunch of his old toys and given them to us, and he had this troll that literally the hair was like in two dreads on top of the head. And I was like, do we need this? Do we need this? And he's like, I've had this since I was like 8. And I'm like, okay, you're 35.
His only toy.
We have other toys. We have other toys for my husband's child that we don't need the troll.
I'm so glad my mom did not keep my troll collection.
Yeah.
Back to
Beanie Babies.
Oh, God.
But look how cute this is. She's so cute.
It's magical.
She's so cute. Oh my gosh. Well, if you guys want to watch more videos like this, I have a bunch of them on my Instagram. And we're going to leave this up so you guys can rewatch it. So thanks for tuning in. Go follow my Instagram. It's Beauty by Miss Ruby. I always post a lot of videos on there and cute little styling tips and my favy little short hairstyles too. I do long hair as well, so I got a bunch of really good long hair videos on there. But thanks for watching, you guys, and we'll see you later.